think I'll turn on
Mark, 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 Mark. If you can't hear me, let me know. I didn't realize I would be speaking after so many people, so I'm going to try to concentrate it into a shorter amount of time. So Mr. Greenberg has just walked into the airport to catch his flight to San Francisco. He walks over to the counter and he starts, you know, giving them his paperwork and stuff. And then he asks the man behind the counter, he says, I know I'm going to San Francisco, but can I ask you if I can take, I'm taking along three pieces of luggage. Can I take one to Australia, one to London, and one to come with me to San Francisco? The man sitting behind the counter is looking at him like he fell off to me. Mr. Greenberg, I don't know where you come up with these ideas. You know we can't do that for you. So this old Mr. Greenberg says, sir, I don't know what you're talking about. Just last week, I took a flight from New York to Texas. And when I got there, my three pieces of luggage, they told me one got to Manchester, one got to Arkansas, and one came along to Texas. So I think we could arrange it again. But anyway, on a more serious note, first of all, thank you all for coming out tonight. I know everybody has their commitments to different things, and you all committed your business to come. We really appreciate it. I just want to thank Hashem for this year. It's really been I can speak for myself, and I know I speak for the other guys as well. It's really been a special year in many, many ways, and one we're never going to forget, and one that I'm very, very sad that it's over, and God willing, we'll be back. And before I say the next thing, I just want to point out that the soul of the program, Rabbi Shapiro, is just an unbelievable person, even among leaders of yeshivas. He's a very, very special person, and that's what sets the tone in the Semicha program. Every single community, every Chabad house and their community that comes along with it, has its unique qualities, its unique things that they bring to the table. And this community as well has many, many different special qualities that we had the privilege of experiencing this year. But I'm going to choose one specific one which I felt really is felt immensely over here. And it's something which starts from Rabbi Chazanov and his wife and family and all the rabbis and their wives and their families. And that is that feeling the pain and joy, feeling the feelings that others are experiencing fully. Whatever another human being in the community is experiencing, they actually feel it themselves. I witnessed it myself when I was in their presence, when word would come in that somebody lost a loved one or somebody was going through a difficult time in whatever area, you felt that they were just feeling that pain themselves. They were feeling that joy themselves. And when the rabbis set that tone, you feel that in the whole community as well. And the whole community has a blessing here that there's a oneness here, there's a unit between all people. And when somebody is going through something difficult, everybody's there with them. And when somebody is going through a joyous time, it's not just, oh, mazel tov, yeah, happy birthday, or, you know, congratulations. But the whole community is truly happy for that person, and it's something which is very unique to this place. And the question is, where does this come from? Where is the inspiration for for everything that goes on here, and especially this idea? Where does it come from? And the answer lies in somebody by the name, as many of you know, the Lubavitcher Rebbe, Rabbi Menachem Mendel Schneerson, whose passing we commemorated 2 days ago, when thousands of people waited in line, including several people here, to get into the resting place of the Rebbe to pray. And his leadership is really what inspires us. And this point, which we just brought out about the community here, this was exemplified by the Rebbe to the ultimate extent. When somebody, you can see those who had the privilege of being by the Rebbe, and even today you can watch the footage, when somebody would come before the Rebbe and mention a certain thing that they're going through, you literally saw the dynamics on the Rebbe changing, and it's literally feeling what the other person is going through, whatever it was. And when somebody would go through happy times, the Rebbe would always ask, because the Rebbe would give blessings and they would be helped, and then people would forget. The Rebbe would always ask, come, tell me when you're helped, tell me when there's good news. And then as well, the Rebbe felt the joy of every person. And what happens is, Rabbi Jonathan Sachs, I recently heard from him, he said that, what gave the Rebbe this strength, this power to make such a transformation? And he said it might be that just as we see the pain that the rabbi felt when any person was going through a small, painful thing in his life. You can imagine an event like the Holocaust, the extent of the horrific annihilation that the Jews experienced, perhaps the biggest in our history. Just imagine what the rabbi was experiencing during and after the Holocaust. If he felt the pain of one Jew so deeply, how much pain did he feel by such an enormous event, such an enormous horrific event occurring? We can't even imagine what he was experiencing. And he says that it could be that the only thing that the Rebbe saw as the ability to fight such darkness is just as every single Jew was once chased down in hate to kill them and to hurt them, we are now going to chase every single Jew in love if they need something physically, emotionally, spiritually, whatever it is. And this is really where this energy comes from, and that's what sets the tone in this Chabadus and in all Chabaduses. There's one other point that I want to point out about the Rebbe and about all of us, is that the Rebbe did not want, this is a mistake that some people make, the Rebbe, many people see the Rebbe as a leader of many thousands of people and thousands of followers. But an important point to remember is that the Rebbe did not want followers. The Rebbe wanted leaders. The Rebbe wanted every single person has their unique traits, their unique capabilities, which only they can do. And the Rebbe wanted you, every single person, to be a leader. You be a leader to your circle of influence. Every single person is a leader to their circle of influence. And just like there's a very great writer, Rabbi Zvi Freeman, he wrote that many others became great leaders because they brought others to believe in them. And the Rebbe became a great leader because he believed so much in us. He believed in the person. He believed in you. He believed in you changing your life, changing the lives of those around you. And we should take this perspective and take this attitude and do our best to lead our circle. Everybody has those that they're connected to, and to help them out physically if they need something, emotionally, and most importantly, spiritually, to help them. When we inspire others, it inspires us as well. And to spread the light of Torah Mitzvot here in Monmouth County and around the whole world. And this should lead us together to bring Mashiach's kingdom now.